wherever you go, you must be very clear from the beginning as to why you have come. What do you want to do? And not to forget that. Not to lose sight of that. If someone loses sight of the goal even a little, the mind immediately becomes extroverted, distracted, and starts falling down. Every student generally says, why are you going to the college? For knowledge. But really, do you attend the classes? No, I attend college every day, but not classes. Mostly all the students go to school, university and all that. They go to get a degree. So what I want to say is, you study. You pass your exams. But not only for degrees, but truly to get that knowledge of that, you must develop that love for learning, love for that knowledge. And that knowledge should be such which should be remembered anytime it is required, and it should bring that positive change in us. Other people would say, what is the use of such a highly literate person and all that? What is his life? It will be an insult to that knowledge. Bring a spirit of service in your life. That with that knowledge, whichever knowledge you have got, degree is only but part of it, first. First part. But true knowledge, true spirit of service, seva, and efficiency, that must come in your life. I am sure that you all know the national anthem of Bharat, India. You know? In that, said Punjab, Sindh, Gujarat, Maratha, Dravida, Utkal, Banga, Vindhya, Himachal, Yamuna, Ganga. You have been chanting that, saying that. It's very interesting, and I'm very pleased to know that almost from 25 states of India, students have come here. Right? So now only, not that you recite that national anthem, but also you know all brothers, sisters have come from various places. Right? I also know that now those who have come from the northern states or Maharashtra or even from Assam and such places, for them Kerala is very, very different. But that's the beauty of our nation also, that our languages are different. Veshabhusha, Keshabhusha, and our Bhojan Bhusha, everything is very, very different and all that. So in English they say variety is a spice of life. So you can see that variety. Now, you all have come here. One thing I know, that generally nobody likes to listen to sermons and advices, right? Don't say no, because I know. If somebody goes on giving upadesh, 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 oh, kahenge har desh mein upadesh suna. हर देश में उपदेश और आदेश और दुनिया भर के निर्देश और हर कोई आता हो कहता है संदेश. सो मेनी लिसन करेक्ट. आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू गिव अ सर्मन और एनीथिंग लाइक दैट. But you see, what I have learned, observed, that only I shall share with you. Okay? What we find, that many times we set forth on a journey or to achieve something, but then something happens in between. Right? And then we are not able to reach that, what we wanted. And not only that, we start seeing many, many problems only. Everywhere problems. Once I read a very good definition of problem. In English, it was said, problem is that which you start seeing when you stop seeing your goal of life. A simple sentence. Difficult? When we stop seeing our goal, we lose sight of that, then suddenly everything starts happening a problem. Now here, as I said, from far off states also you have come here. And if you know why you have come, it is all wonderful. But otherwise, what the climate of this state, you know. Kerala. Climate is not good. And food. Very good. If you feel very good, very nice. But what I'm saying, if you lose sight of goal, then what will happen? That I'm saying. Coconut oil. Everything is in coconut oil. Idli dosa. कोई पंजाब को कुलचा वगैरह तो कुछ मिलता ही नहीं ना परोठा कुलचा एंड यू नो कोई राजमा वगैरह तो कुछ मिलता ही नहीं ओनली सांभर हाउ लॉन्ग विल से हैव बीन ईटिंग इडली इडली दे आर कमिंग आउट थ्रू माय ईयर्स इफ सच थिंग इज नॉट हैपनिंग टू यू आई एम वेरी हैप्पी But what I want to say is, question is not only of this place. Wherever we may be, somewhere we have to be. And we have to achieve something. So only one thing I have to say is that wherever you go, you must be very clear from the beginning as to why you have come. What do you want to do? And not to forget that. Not to lose sight of that. Now we are in Adi Shankaran lamp here. Shankaracharya wrote a very beautiful shloka. And you know, the beauty of his language is a very simple language. Anyone who knows even little Sanskrit grammar also can understand the meaning. He said, Lakshachutam ched edi chittam ishat bahirmukham san nipate tadasada. If someone loses sight of the goal even a little, the mind immediately becomes extrovert, distracted and starts falling down. Taka taka taka. Like what? So he gave an example. Pramadata prachyuta kelikandukaha sopana panktau padito yathadata. Somebody is coming down from the staircase and in his hand there was a rubber ball or tennis ball and playing with him. And slipped from his hand. Now you know that if that tennis ball falls on one step, then next we don't know, it bounces on which step it will go down. And if you try to catch that, what will happen to you also? You also topple down, right? One man came down from the staircase like that. Somebody asked him, did you miss a step? He said, no, I hit each and every step of that. I didn't miss a single step. Gone, that ball, where is gone? Don't know. Our mind become like that. Whether we are driving motorbike or a car or what, and now the big billboard of advertisements and all that, would know, very attractive. This. Huh? And driving. Attraction. And then attraction caused distraction. And distraction caused destruction. Huh? And it doesn't take long time. Huh? Just a fraction of a second. Huh? That's why in the Hindi, you know, language on that, you must have seen so many boards, you know, driving and mountainous road. Savdhani hati. Or aage kya? Durghatna ghati. Means you lose that alertness. And immediately Ram Nam Satya. You just, you don't know what can happen in that one fraction of a second, you see. Huh? So we have to be very alert. So when this thing happens, you see, keep on happening. So you have to come, when you have come here, you should know why you have come. Why you have come. Then you may say, yeah, I know. You don't have to tell that. If somebody goes to a college or university and all that, okay, city biranical thodi aate. So when he comes to the university, Vishwa Vidya Pitham and all that. So I come here to study, to learn. Every student generally says, why are you going to the college? For knowledge. But really, do you attend the classes? No, I attend college every day, but not classes. Attending college is one thing, attending class is different thing. Actually, what is happening is, mostly all the students go to school, university and all that, they go to get a degree. One boy told me, I never go, I'm pushed to go there. Others said, if I don't have a degree, how will I get a job? And if I don't have a job, how will I get married? So he's going to college for getting married. Wow, wow, wow. So we may say we are going for studying, learning, and this and that, but what are we going only for degree? So a degree you may get, but we don't know whether you get knowledge or not. Because we are memorizing many things, this, that, we can get a degree also. Copying also. There are so many ways people just get a degree. Just because one has got a degree, not necessary that person has gained knowledge also. So it should become clear. Yes, it is true that we are going there so that we learn and we get a degree, which is necessary for getting a job, for our livelihood. and for all our whatever the life you want to lead. But that cannot be the goal, final goal. Okay? So what I want to say is, you study, you pass your exams, but not only for degrees, but truly to get that knowledge of that, you must develop that love for learning, love for that knowledge. See, we have seen that so many great poets, writers, thinkers, they were there. Many of them did not have any university degrees. They were not very literate. But do you know, so many people are getting doctorate degrees on their work. Did Kabirdasji go to any school? No. But people are getting degree on his work also. So that is something different altogether. So you have come here. So also know, from practical purpose it is true. And your family people also expect that only. That you should learn and all that. And very great system is there, you know. A grade, straight A, A plus grade, they go on getting, right? I don't know what system is here, how they get. But one boy, you know, used to get A grade. Then slowly he got B. You know why? You know? And third time, his father asked, what are your grades? He said, I am underwater. The father didn't understand. What is underwater degree? What is that grade? Below sea level. A grade. Then B. C. After A, B, C. Below sea level. Underwater. In this way, degrade. He degraded himself. Again, why? Lost sight. So, learn, get degree, but develop love for that subject, love for that knowledge. And next, that knowledge should be such. You just now say the prayer every day. I think you say, Om Sahana Bhavatu, Sahana Bhunaktu. I don't know how much attention we give to their meaning and all that. But one word, one sentence there is, Tejasvinavadhitamastu. May our learning be bright and brilliant. Right? The word is there, no? Om Sahanavavatu, Sahanovunaktu, Sahaviryam Karavavahai. Tejasvinavade tamastu ma vidvisha vahai. What is the meaning of knowledge, tejasvi? Bright knowledge means, one meaning is, whenever you need, it is available. Do you know the meaning of the? It is there in computer. Let me check. Everything is in computer. Okay, go and check. Usko virus lag gaya hai. Usko virus lag gaya hai. I don't know how to clean it. I don't know virus computer ko laga hai ki tumhare dimag ko laga hai. Where is that virus? That's not bright knowledge. Suppose a student is there. Before going to that examination hall, he knows everything. After he comes out also, he knows everything. Only for 3 hours, nothing. Blank. But more serious meaning is, our knowledge is bright when there is transformation in us according to that knowledge. Suppose there is a smoker, cigarette smoker, and then he comes to know how dangerous it is, or injurious it is for health, and he gives up that, then we say that his knowledge is tejasvi, right? But even after knowing and everywhere seeing that how it is injurious to health, and he goes on smoking, so his knowledge is not bright, it is smoky. Because it had not brought any kind of change. So, degree, yes. But love for learning is still greater. And that knowledge should be such, which should be remembered anytime it is required. And it should bring that positive change in us. Other people would say, what is the use of such a highly literate person and all that? What is his life? It will be an insult to that knowledge. And next is this jnanam. What you got? With that jnanam, that spirit of service, not only earning money. See, if you have got a degree, you will get a job and other things, you will get money also. But what is important, it should bring a spirit of service in your life. That with that knowledge, whichever knowledge you have got, art and commerce and science and technology, or Sanskrit, Vyakaran, Advait, Vedanta, whichever, whatever knowledge you have. Spirit of seva. Remember, seva service is not a particular act. Only sweeping the floor is not only the seva. Mahatma Gandhiji said, there is not a single moment in man's life when he cannot serve. Every moment. Right? It is not a particular kind of act. So with your knowledge, you serve, you don't have to go everywhere, but wherever you live, all around you, who are there, you serve. And that service should be with great dexterity, skill. What is the dexterity? It has got so many meanings in the sense, sometimes people may not appreciate whatever you are doing. They may not be very grateful, thankful. But you should not lose your heart and you go on doing it. The world is peculiar. But while doing seva, kaushalam should be there, that you should know what kind of help the other person needs, and then you should do that. Suppose somebody says feeding other person is very good thing, and that man is already overeaten. Come, sit down. One young boy came home and he told his father, Daddy, I did a very good job today. What? I help one old lady cross the road. Oh, very good. Then she must have been very happy. The boy said, no, she was very angry with me. Why? Because she didn't want to cross. So she was cross with me. But she didn't want to cross, then why you are lifting her and taking it to other side? Kaushalam. First is called jnanam. Knowledge that should give the spirit of service, seva, and in that doing seva, kushalta should be there, skill, dexterity, efficiency. What kind of seva, who needs at a given time, and how to do it. And that person may be thankful or not thankful, doesn't matter. But when you have done your best, that's the end of it. So this is the purpose for which you have come here. Okay? Degree is only one part of it, first part. But true knowledge, true spirit of service, seva, and efficiency, that must come in your life. At this moment, you may not appreciate everything what I have said, but when you go through your life, you will understand. I think the rain's asking me to stop. Okay. But I don't have to say more anyway. This much only I wanted to say. And this goal you must remember here. This is a very different kind of university. Remember that and go ahead. Swastiva paraya tamasa parastat shubhaste panthanaha santu. May all your paths be clear and God's grace be always with you. Thank you. Hari Om.